Very good morning, dear children. Today we are going to see a lesson, seventh lesson, last lesson in your sixth standard first term, Computer and Introduction. By learning this lesson, we come to know about the computer and know the history of computer. You could understand the growth and development of computer, and you can understand the generation of computer, and also you understand the types of computer. And you can easily apply the knowledge of computer in various fields in our day-to-day life. This is an introduction about a computer. Nowadays, the technology developed a wide. Without a computer, we cannot imagine a field, any official or inofficial systems. We depends upon the computer. The computer makes our life very easy, makes the mathematics very easy. The world become very short. Under one roof, the world comes under one roof with the help of computer. So it is important to know about computer and how it is working. Here in your sixth standard first term, they just give you an introduction. You might have learnt about it in your previous classes. If you are studied in your matriculation means in your computer education, you might have studied about these things. But as it is this Samachir syllabus, this is the first lesson, an introduction lesson about computer. So very basic things are given about the computer. Here in this lesson, they discuss about the computer using a conversation. So at your home, you go through the conversation, try to read out. By that, you can enrich your English vocabulary. Also, you can gain knowledge. But now I am not going to read out all the conversation. Instead, I am going to highlight the points alone. Okay. So what is a computer? Your father may have a mobile phone. Many of you may have a mobile phone because in our classes are going through this mobile phone. So this mobile phone is also like a computer. That is the first point. So how it is a computer? We usually think that computer, this is the explanation. Computer should be like a big TV or a box attached with it. But computers are available in different shapes. The works which are done with a computer can also be done using a smartphone. There may be difference in their speed, but their operation remains the same. Speed may differ, but their operation remains the same. The big computer are shrunk into small smartphone nowadays because of the technological development. Most of us think that smartphones are only to make call because it is handy look. But it doesn't mean. It also work like a smartphone. Work like a computer. All these things. For a computer, நான் இதெல்லாம் செய்யணும் அப்படின்னா எனக்கு சில டேட்டாஸ் வேணும், எம்எஸ் ஆஃபீஸ் வேணும், இந்த டாக்குமெண்ட்ஸை காட்டுறதுக்கு. நான் இதை ஹைலைட் பண்ணி உங்களுக்கு காட்டுறேன் அப்படின்னா அதுக்கு ஒரு தனி ஆப் வேணும், தனி ஒரு டேட்டாபேஸ் வேணும். இந்த மாதிரி நிறைய ஆப்ரேஷன்ஸ் இருக்குது. பட் இந்த ஸ்மார்ட் ஃபோன்லேயே நான் உங்களுக்கு என்ன பண்ணிடுறேன்னா, எதை ஹைலைட் பண்ணணுமோ ஹைலைட் பண்ணி காட்டுறேன், எடிட் பண்ணுறதை எடிட் பண்ணுறோம், பிக்சர்ஸை க்ராப் பண்ணுறோம். இதுக்கெலாம் ஃபோட்டோஷாப்னு ஒரு இதுக்கு போகணும், ஒரு ஆப்ஷனுக்கு போகணும் நம்ம கம்ப்யூட்டரில். ஆனால் மொபைல்லே நீங்கள் என்ன செஞ்சிடுறீங்க, ஃபோட்டோஸ் எடிட் பண்ணிடுறீங்க, டேட்டாஸை காமிச்சிடுறீங்க, கால்குலேஷன்ஸ் வேணும்னா போட்டு காட்டுறீங்க. ஸோ யூ கேன் டூ எவ்ரி திங் யூஸிங் அ கம்ப்யூட்டர். கால்குலேட்டரில் போய் கால்குலேஷன் போடுறீங்க. யூ கேன் யூஸ் எவ்ரி திங் using a smartphone as in the computer. So your smartphone is a mini computer. Okay. The Selvi asked another question, laptop and tablets. Regarding laptops and tablets, laptop tablets um computers da, and a different type of computer. Their performance vary according to their capacity. லேப்டாப் ஓட கெப்பாசிட்டிக்கு ஏற்ற மாதிரி அதோட பெர்ஃபார்மன்ஸ் மாறும். அது உங்களுக்கே தெரியும், வீட்டில் லேப்டாப் வச்சுருந்தீங்கன்னா யூ கம் டு நோ தட். நெக்ஸ்ட் குவஸ்டின், கம்ப்யூட்டர் ஏன் தேவை, ஒரு ஸ்டூடெண்ட்க்கு எதுக்காக கம்ப்யூட்டர் தேவை? உடனே நீங்கள் என்ன சொல்வீங்க, வி வாண்ட் டு பிளே வீடியோ கேம்ஸ். நோ, நாட் அட் ஆல். டு ட்ரா, டு பெயிண்ட், டு பிளே கேம்ஸ், அண்ட் யூ கேன் லேர்ன் அண்ட் டெவலப் யுவர் ஜென்ரல் நாலேஜ் யூசிங் திஸ் கம்ப்யூட்டர். ஓகே. ஸோ இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் பேஜ் தே எக்ஸ்பிளைன் மோர் அபவுட் த கம்ப்யூட்டர். லெட் சி அபவுட் இட். நவ் த டீச்சர் என்டர்ட் இன் டு திஸ் கான்வர்சேஷன். What is a computer? This is the definition for computer. You have to learn the definition. Computer is an electronic device that processes the data and information according to our needs. We can save the data and convert it into information. Computers are used in many ways. So this is the definition for computer. Computer is nothing but an electronic device. Okay. Who invented the computer? In the beginning of 19th century, Charles Babbage, a professor of mathematics, has designed an analog computer. He is known as the father of the computer. Analog computer, nowadays we are using digital computer. Analog computer is different, digital computer is different. You will be learning about that in later classes. Okay. He is known as father of computer. Who is the father of computer? Charles Babbage is the father of computer. Okay. Then it is further modified by many scientists. The Augusta Ada Lovelace. Lady, okay, Augusta Ada Lovelace is admired as the first programmer. First programmer developed essential commands for the mathematics operation. Okay, so what is the forefather or primitive invention before computer to do mathematical operation? Initially, computers are invented to do mathematical operation only. Okay, initially. Later it developed its skill and the further operations are modified or developed in the computer itself. Okay, so in the beginning, what is used as a computer? In the beginning, abacus is used for mathematical operation. See, in the picture they have given abacus for calculation. So in the beginning they use abacus for calculations. Calculations kaga abacus tha use pannanga. Innu adutadut nariya calculating machines irukku. I am going to share you a link. Or a link ungalku share panna poren. Adha history of computer pathi nalla detail ah irukku. You idoda kuda neenga andha link ayum paarenga, ungalku nalla interesting ah irukum, puriyum. Next, the teacher explained about the computer did not comes directly from abacus. Abacus la irundhu direct ah vandhathu computer appdin solli solla mudiyadhu. Adha sonnen adutha adutha rendu moonu computing devices, mathematical devices irundhathu. Adukku adutha stage ah dhaan computer develop aanadhu. Ippo unga kaiyila irukka computer 5th generation computer. The computer that you have in your hand is 5th generation. What is the meaning? Before that there were 4 more generations. So what is the used in 1st generation? The 1st generation computer, they use vacuum tubes. They use vacuum tubes. In the 2nd generation computer, they use transistors. In the 3rd generation computer, they use integrated circuits. In the 4th generation computer, they use microprocessor. In the 5th generation computer, they use artificial intelligence. So these are all may be asked in your match. Okay. Then what are datas and what are informations? Two important element of computers are datas and informations. Okay. Let's know what is data. Data means is information that has to be processed. It can be used directly by us. Generally they are in the form of numbers. I repeat, data is the information that has to be processed. It cannot be used directly by us. Generally they are in the form of numbers, alphabets and images. So they cannot be used directly, they will be in the form of numbers, alphabets and images. And what is information? What is information? Information is a form of processed data. So what is software and hardware? We frequently come across the word software and hardware while using a computer. So what is that software? What is that hardware? First we let us know about software. The commands or the programs that are used in computer are called software. The software can be divided into two types. One is operating software, another one is application software. The Linux, Windows, these are all operating software. For a computer to run, it needs some operating software like Linux and Windows. While switch on the computer, log in to the computer, it initially shows Windows and its version. Okay, so this is operating software. Software that is used to operate the computer is called operating software. Example for this are Windows and Linux. What is application software? Application software is the software that is used to run a particular program. For example, the software used for painting, playing games in computer or application software. For various uses, we have some other application softwares. Yes, in the painting, 2D painting and 3D paintings are there. If you install that 3D painting, then only you can do that. Animation is available in your computer. That is a separate app. So you have to install those application software in your computer. Then only you can do that applications. Is it clear? Then they asked about hardware. What is hardware? The part that are available in the computer that helps the software to work is a hardware. So lot of hardwares are there. You can see lot of hardwares. What are they? Monitor, CPU, etc. Okay. So what do you know about input devices? So whatever we want to send to a computer is sent through a device called input device. What are the input devices? Examples for input devices are keyboard, mouse, other input devices. Okay, these are all input devices. Keyboard, mouse, usually we are using these only. There are some other input devices are there. So using that we can feed data into the computer. What are output devices? The data or information that has been sent to the computer are displayed out or reproduced through some devices. These are called output devices. So idha nam enna solrona output devices. Idella output devices, monitor, printer, so on. Idellame namak enadhu output devices. What is a CPU? Central processing unit is called as CPU. CPU means central processing unit. You will learn and understand more about CPU in your higher classes. So up to this, they have explained about computer in your 6th standard. I hope you all understand and enjoy the lesson. I will share you a link regarding this computer to make your learning more interesting. Thank you, girls.